Good afternoon, ladies and gentle guardians. So today we've got a weapon that is pretty different than all other fusions I've ever used before. This fusion rifle, I got it a while back in the Wrath of the Machine raid. That's Scourge of the Past. I don't know why I always flip off those. I got it back in the Scourge of the Past raid, and it's disgusting. Like, don't underestimate it. You may look at this and see, like, oh, okay, it's a 740 charge time, precision frame. It's not high impact, so I'm not going to use it. And that's what a lot of people are going to think. But, I decided to give this thing a spin, and it's something else. I'll say that. It is definitely something else. Now, you may be wondering what makes this gun so special. And that is this perk right here, opening shot. Now, if you're familiar with Destiny 2 PvP, you know opening shot is an insane, insane perk. And the fact that this is on a fusion rifle actually blows me away. And I feel like a lot of people don't even know that this perk can roll on this fusion rifle. It's insane. I'm pretty sure that opening shot, I'm pretty sure that this is the only fusion rifle. Quote me if I'm wrong. Or don't quote me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure this is the only fusion rifle in the entire game that can roll with opening shot. It is disgusting. It is very good. So the perks that I have on mine is this scope. I'm not going to try pronouncing that, which increases the range, which is always great. And then I got this, which also increases the range. And then we got opening shot and then rampage. By no means is it a god roll. It's far from it. Obviously, I probably would have wanted to go for something that would increase the charge time a little bit, but I forgot the perk was, but it increases the damage. And then I love rampage opening shot. I probably wouldn't change this. I think it's a great combination. The fact that opening shot procs pretty much every single time you fire the weapon. That is how ridiculous it is. You know, in addition to rampage, which just really helps get the streaks going, right? Kill one guy, the next guy. And it helps because this thing doesn't hit quite as hard as the high impact fusions. Not only that, but it's a lot more forgiving. So I can land a shot, or let's say I miss a couple pellets and they don't die. I can follow up with that and have a higher chance of killing them versus if I was using, obviously, air and till. And then I got a handling masterwork, which isn't great. I mean, it's fine. But it's good. Honestly, I would have went for stability for obvious reasons, but handling's fine. It gets the job done. It actually helps this thing actually feel very snappy. This fusion rifle feels amazing in the hand. And then we also have targeting adjuster. Strangely enough, I think this thing actually shoots... Sorry about that, my headset's being stupid. I think this thing actually shoots vertically enough. I was playing with it and I'm like, oh, at first I tried, counterbalance, and I was like, it's fine, but something feels a little weird about it. And then I went to targeting adjuster and it just felt better. Like, it still was vertical enough, but at the same time it almost felt like the pellets were more compact and obviously more of them landed. So my play would definitely be targeting adjuster. This thing is just disgusting. Let's see if I can get it for the thumbnail. Can I get it? Yes, just barely. All right, awesome. But yeah, this thing is just straight up disgusting. And I'm sure you guys have heard enough of me talking. I'm gonna show you guys how much this thing slays. So let's get right into the crucible. You know, I thought they fixed the black screen. Oh, that's so annoying, bro. That's really annoying. I've been using Redrix a little bit more. Look how nice this thing looks. It's so nice and handling's good. Nice and thin. It's not chunky, that's what I'm getting at. You know, I thought that was a valiant strategy, honestly. I didn't think he was gonna be big dumb dumb and like actually push me, but yeah, that's fine. See, I don't know if you saw that. That was with no counterbalance. You almost don't even really need it because it's so... I mean, like, yeah, I'm managing it, but it by itself is actually very good. The recoil is very, very good.
I don't know why we always get the bad maps when I'm recording. But it's fine. This one's actually pretty close quarters, so it actually favors this weapon, so I don't really care. Super Pedo! Alright, it's cool. We're tied right now. I gotta get this ball rolling. This isn't very interesting. Oh, got him. Let's go. Let's get this zone. Ow! Get out. Shoo. Nobody wants that here. Alright. I had Desperado, and I traded with a gnawing hunger. What the fuck? Bungie! Like, what the excuse my French, but what the hell? That is not okay. Love this fusion. It's so good. Isn't like, honestly, I think just seeing a fusion charge up that fast is such a breath of fresh air. It is so nice. Oh, kind of yoinked that, but... Oh, we were hitting all crits too. If I got Desperado, that would have been sick. It's okay. I went on a crazy Desperado tear last game. I got like... 4 or 5 just Desperado kills in a row. It was so fun. Oh my gosh, this gun is so cool. Shut the enemy down. This fusion's amazing! Zone B locked. Please, please, I want to show the range. Push me. Ha! Thank you, I appreciate it. Oh, thank you for the wall. I appreciate it. Look at that, I'm playing objective! We actually be doing objective, let's go. Yes! We traded!
This is so fun. I love, dude, this setup is so good. I think I might want to use it in like comp. It's so much fun. Again, I'm sorry, I'm kind of like Nick Merckx in it. Sorry if my logo's in the way. Just thought I should mention that. I really don't want to move the camera though, because if I do that, sometimes it freezes up on me, and you guys know how that goes.
Oh my god! That was hipfire! Oh my, it just like sniped him from around the corner. Oh my, I actually wasn't expecting that. That was disgusting. Am I panicking this? Yes, yes I am. But! Hey dude. A double kill? I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that. I'd say that is not a waste. I am perfectly content. Ah, oh, come on. No, I wanted to help kill. Alright, let's get this zone. Aw, I didn't get special. What a shame. Oh my gosh! I can't believe we even lived for that long. Come on, get him! Get him, team up on him! Alright, we're good. Oh my gosh, no, that was just my fault. That was just all my fault. I just missed the first burst. That was all on me. Ow, 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 ow. Team! Kill him! We gotta make sure we control these zones or else they might come back. Not good. I need to use the fusion more. Stop using broadsword, Michael. What are you doing? No, 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 no. Come on. Come on, I got him down half. Help me out here. Alright. I did a roll. I did a thing that helped my team. That is a win. Man, these 600s, I don't know about them sometimes. I really don't. Like, Bungie, I like the time to kill being fast, but you gotta do something else about the other autos, because as of right now, all the other auto rifles are completely useless. That's disgusting. I love Despero. All the other auto rifles are useless. There's no point in using any of them. Like, not to mention that pretty much one of the best primaries in the entire game is, like, the easiest weapon to get. Like, in the entire game. I mean, obviously that's exaggerating, but it's one of the easiest weapons to get. Woo! Alright, that was stupid. I shouldn't have pushed with a Desperado, but it's okay. Alright, let's do it. Ow, somebody help me! That was the most frustrating engagement ever. I put like half my fusion shots into him and meleeed, and he still lived, and then he just meleeed me a second time. Alright, we're fine. We're not fine, but as a team, we're fine. Alright, let's see if I can get at least one more good something. Just at least one more good something. Oh, he's coming around. Thank you. Ow, I don't have fusion, I'm freaking screwed. Hit fire! Oh, we're screwed, we're dead. He's dead. I'm soon to be dead! Oh my gosh, no. No, please. Let's hold it. Dang it, are they actually gonna do this to us? They're actually gonna do this to us. That's a sword! See, now, in that situation, if I had a Arantil, a high impact, I would have been dead. I would have just been dead. Like, I wouldn't have made it out of that. I like it. Honestly, it feels like it's almost just as consistent as a high impact fusion rifle. Feels almost just as consistent as a high impact fusion rifle. And it fires faster. Like, opening shot really does wonders on that thing. It's ridiculous. And I know that wasn't like the best game like ever, but you guys get the point. There were some decent kills there, and I feel like it looked okay. Anyway, there you guys have it. That is the Tempered Dynamo, a fusion rifle that unfortunately is gonna be it's pretty limited. This one specifically with opening shot is very limited, especially because not only do you have to go into the raid, but then in that raid, you then have to get a Tempered Dynamo to drop. And then once you get the Tempered Dynamo to drop, there's only a chance of it being opening shot. I'm honestly surprised I even managed to get this roll to begin with. But yes, if you have a Tempered Dynamo sitting around and it has opening shot on it and you didn't know that it was that good, please try it, give it a spin, because if I'm being honest, I have a really nicely rolled Trials Fusion, and I love it, but honestly, I'm not sure. This one I almost might like just as much or even more. I'm not sure. Now, it is unfortunate. This is an older weapon, so after this season, you won't be able to quite use it for the higher level stuff, but for comp and quick play and everything, it's still a great weapon, and I think it's a ton of fun. This thing is a blast, and opening shot really does make a difference. Like, you may think, like, oh, well, what's the big deal? Like... how much is it actually going to change it? But I mean, when you take into account what opening shot does, like increased accuracy and range, let alone the fact that I have a range perk and scope that also increases the range. I mean, like, I get it that it's like
range isn't as important anymore on fusions just because, like, of the whole nerf and everything, and if I'm being personal about it, I probably prefer stability. Opening shot, it's that accuracy buff that really improves this gun. Because think about it, the downside of these lower impact fusions is that you in turn have to land more pellets to get the kill. What opening shot does, and since it procs pretty much on every single burst, unless you're firing it super fast, is it allows more of those pellets to land. And that's what makes this fusion so, so good. Not only that, it feels amazing, and over, I mean, I just haven't been having a great time with it. Also, the scope is really nice, but I mean, there you go. That's my hot take on it, you guys. That's how I feel about the gun. I think it's very good. It's unfortunate that it's so limited. Like, it's not easy to get your hands on, but if you did get your hands on this, please, please use it. It is a gem that I feel like nobody knows about. And I feel like most people don't even know that opening shot is even capable of rolling on a fusion rifle. I'm pretty sure this is the only one that it can roll on. Because, like, think about it. If opening shot can roll on a high impact, think about how broken that would be. It's very good. So if you are going to try and get it, I wish you luck. Scourge of the Past Raid is where you get this from. It is unfortunate they might be removing it. I hope not. I really hope that isn't one of the things that they're vaulting, but it's just worth mentioning. So, well, I've been talking for long enough. You guys know my thoughts on it. It's a great gun. Please, highly recommend it. And I think that's all I got to say for you guys. So remember to stay as positive as possible, and I'll see you guys in the next video.